Hi, it's Binni here, Binni from Online Forex Master. Today I want to talk about the use of the SGX fund flow. Right, SGX will publish this fund to show the fund flow of what happened last week. Alright, so for example, I have the fund flow that's downloaded today on the 2nd of August and is showing what happened on the week of 26th July. So that's last week. Some of you might be asking me, hey, look, isn't that late? It doesn't really matter because then we're going to take a look at to see into the general environment. And personally, I've used that and I have taught it to the group of the IBF course participants that I'm teaching who is using this as an aid to help them to trade into SIMSCI, which is the Singapore Free Index Futures. All right, and if you know that and you have read the Chinese newspaper Lian He Zao Bao, I'm also one of the commentators who will comment regularly on the use of the fund flow and then what kind of information we can gather from the fund flow. All right, so the first thing that I want to do is I want to talk about how to use the fund flow here. All right, so there are four tabs. One would be the weekly top 10. The other one will be institutional, retail, and STI constituents. All right. What is more important is to understand the inflow and the outflow of the institutions. All right. So let's take a look at what's happening this week here. All right. So this week we have the volume, which is the net overall volume of the inflow and the outflow. And then after these figures, it will come up with the overall volume of the total, whether it's in or out, right, for the institutional investors. So when we see that it is red, that means that there is a net sell. Okay, so there's a net outflow of the funds of all these stocks here. All right, so what is important is that in the fund flow report is listed a trend. It doesn't give you only 1 week. So it's good that if you can tabulate all the different weeks, right, to see a trend. But I have here in SGX data, which is 4 weeks. So that is the full July, the month of July here. So in the month of July, what is very stunning and very important is that last week there was a high number, because if you take a look at the overall inflow and outflow, which is the net buy or net sell, any figure which is near to 500 or 600 is considered quite a high number. All right, so we have this last week the number which is near to 400, especially when STI is near to a high. So later we can take the current number that we know, that means what the institutions are doing, to go and understand what is happening to the STI. So as of last week, right, the net flow is an outflow of money, which means it's a net sell. And especially coming into the net sell would be things like the financial service, that's the banks, all right. And then we have consistently the industrial. But one very, very important piece of information is that the increase in the net sell, right, of the institutions on the financial services. Okay, so that means that as we start to see the banks getting expensive, that was a net sell from the financial on the financial services from institutional investors. All right, so the other important thing is that we are having a little bit of a more net sell, all right, in the REITs. Okay, so we can see a trend of sell in the REITs. So that's probably because that the REITs are right now announcing the first half of the earnings, all right, and then giving out the dividends. So they could be selling after they have received the dividends, that's XD, or where price has already appreciated and REITs could be a little bit high, right? But anyway, the net sell of the REITs isn't very high right now. Okay, let's take a look at what the institutions, what they sold. So last week they sold into DBS and UOB, so that's the top two stocks that they sold. Of course, then we have the OCBs coming in here, right? IFAS is also something that's important because IFAS had a shooting star pattern in the week chart, all right. And then of course that Wilma is right now currently still in the downtrend. One of the things is, you know, reference medical is what the first time that I've seen that it appear in the past 6 months, or at least in the past 1 year. So Because of this, all right, it's not surprising to see that actually Raffles Medical is one of the better performance last week, and also in fact that this week has been doing very well since I last talked about it around the price of 105 to 110. Right now it's trading about 140 already. There are some other REITs, and then I think what's interesting is that the fund was buying into SPH, and today SPH was halted, they shared about the privatization of SPH, right? That's interesting. So from the fund flow, we can see, hey, look, those stocks that are moving, there must be a reason in it, right? So that's because last week the funds are looking at them, all right? So let's take a look into the SDI chart, because last week there was quite a large net outflow. This is the SDI chart, the weekly chart. Right, I'm just going to highlight on a few things. Number one is that for the past many weeks, in fact, for the past months, we don't really see STI moving in a trending manner. What we've seen is that the movement of STI is pretty much flat. Okay, so STI is being resisted into this place here. Okay, and then into this place here as a support. Okay, so we have the resistance into STI at this high and then at this low here. If we tally the fund flow, right, so the net outflow, the high of net outflow, the net sell happened somewhere at this bar here. In fact, that for the past weeks, that means if we take a look at the past 4 weeks, there was some net sell, but the net sell wasn't that high versus the last week. So this was a week of a net sell, this one, at about 400 plus million. Seeing such a high number near to a key resistance is not very good news. Although there might be chances that price might still continue to go up, but that definitely shows a bit of a sign of a distribution here. Right, now let me just check the higher time frame chart, because what I always like to do is just to move to the higher time frame chart. And right now I'm at the monthly chart. Right, so where is this current level of 3002? If you remember what happened during last year, the COVID period, so this was that last year during the Jan and the Feb, that was the start of the COVID period, and then price dropped. So that there is a definitely some resistance coming inside here, okay, at around 3200. So it's not surprising why we start to see last week that the funds are starting to sell a little bit in higher volume. All right. Although it hasn't confirmed that price is coming back down, but it's very important to note key levels here. What are the key levels that we are noting here? All right. Of course, then at the low here, we are still seeing a support of 3001. Okay. But in the near term, price shouldn't close below 3150. Right, because if it's going to close below 3150, it just firm up that the resistance here at 3002 is going to be very strong and supported with that net sell. Right, then the outlook of STI isn't looking very nice for the moment. This is Raffles Medical, where we saw which is the top 10 institution net buy last week. Right. Well, a few things. Number one is that from Tor, we already had a few buying signal. So we had this buy signal around here. So the price was around 110, where we had a weak wash and rinse. So that's a very nice buy. And then followed by another one more buy near to the 120 region. Now, one to point out is that at around this price where Tor had a buy signal, that's also a place that you want to take note, because for the first time that the Raffles Medical actually closed above the cluster of highs here. So it has been consolidating at around as in a resistance level, right, around this level for quite some time, and then on the buy signal that happened, and then slightly below it, right, that's where the Tor had a buy signal at about 1.2, and right now it's trading at 1.42, right. Of course, then at this moment it's hitting a bit of a resistance right now, but we can continue to monitor if there's any buy signals coming in, right. I mean, we just have to look out for the Tor buy signal. The second on the list is Maple Tree Industrial Trust. That was last week on the second on the list. All right. Same thing that funds bought in. So that was where they bought in around this long candle here. But it is heading to some resistance already. We can continue to monitor. To me, it's into a zone of resistance, right? In fact, that for MIT, they bought in much earlier, so it could be the second wave of buying in. But based on the TOR signal, the best point to buy in will be around the two arrows that's being indicated here, and that's around the 270 to 280. All right, that would be a 20 cents gain, of course, at the low here, about 260, 270. All right, so for me, I always think that we should be buying on a retracement at the turning point, and that's what the TOR indicator can spot. All right, so but I will be definitely monitor into the some of the other trades that appear in the top 10 institution net buy. All right, so I'm just going to cover again next week on what is happening to the fund flow. Thanks a lot for listening and joining this session.